Now let's see about file system structure. A file is a collection of related information. If you take a text file, it contains that file in related information. If you take a C file, then it contains C related information like that. Generally, file system can be stored on secondary storage device such as hard disk. A file system allows us to store data on the hard disk, as well as we can search for the files in the hard disk so that we can perform operations on the file which is stored in the hard disk in an efficient manner. So that is possible with the help of file system. So in order to make all those activities to be happen, file system is organized into several layers. So these are the layers which we have. So that's why it is known as layered file system. Why? Because the file system is organized into several layers. The top layer is application program, whereas the bottom layer is devices. So in between we have a logical file system, file organization module, basic file system and I/O control. So let's see all the layers one by one. So here the first one is application program. The program which is developed by the user is known as application program. So application program is nothing but the file which is written by the user. Let us assume that we want to take some printout. So that program is nothing but our application program. That file is nothing but our application program. Let us assume that we have written a C program. Okay. So that program is nothing but our application program. Okay. So application program is nothing but a program or file. So that file will be given as input to the logical file system. So the logical file system will checks whether that file is present in directory structure or not. If the file is present in the directory structure, then it finds the location of the corresponding file. So in which location the corresponding file is present, as well as it finds the logical block number. Here we have a logical block number as well as a physical block number. A logical block number corresponds to the file. So which block we are accessing, whether we are accessing a first file, first block or second block or third block like that. Whereas physical block number specifies the exact block number in which the file is stored in the hard disk. Here a hard disk is organized into several blocks. In the blocks, the file will be stored. So that is the task of logical file system. So logical file system accepts file name as the input and checks whether that file is present in directory structure or not. If the file is present in the directory structure, then it finds the location of the file as well as the logical block number of that file. So that's why it is named as logical file system. Why? Because it finds the logical block number. And that logical block number will be given as input to the file organization module. So file organization module accepts logical block number as the input and it performs a mapping or translation scheme in order to find the physical block number in which the file is stored in the hard disk. So the task of file organization module is it finds the physical block number for the corresponding logical block number. So what is a physical block number? It specifies the exact block numbers in which the file is stored in the hard disk. Okay. So for that it uses some directory structures and free space management, all those techniques. Okay. So now it finds the physical block number. That block number will be given as input to the basic file system. Now basic file system issues a command to the I/O control with the help of block number. Here let the block number is 123. Okay. So read 123. So read the content from the block number 123. Or let us assume that the operation is like this. Let here the block number is write. So write some content into the block number 123 or print 123. So the content of 123 will be printed on the monitor. Okay. Here every I/O control contains device drivers or driver files. So what the basic file system will do is a basic file system issues a command to the device drivers with the help of the block number, like read that block number, write block number, append block number, print block number. So the corresponding command will be sent to the IO control. Now IO control accept the command which is sent by the basic file system. We know that every IO control contains a device driver file. Every hardware component contains some device driver file. Keyboard has a driver file, printer has a driver file, hard disk has a driver file, cache has a driver file. So every hardware component in the computer contains a driver file. It is the duty of the device driver file in order to work with or in order to communicate with the devices. So here IO control contains device driver files. So device driver files takes the responsibility of interacting with devices so that the corresponding operation will be done. Let here the operation is read 123. Let here we are reading data from a file. That file is available in some hard disk. So now here hard disk driver file interacts with hard disk in order to read the block number 123 from the file. So this is about file system structure. So in order to work easily with file system, that file system is organized into several layers. Top layer is application program, whereas the bottom layer is devices. Okay, each layer produces output. That output will be passed as input to the next layer. So this is about file system structure.